watching KSBW Action News 8 at 6 with Dan Green, Aaron Clark, Sports with Dennis Lennon, and Weather Plus with Jim Vanderswan. Now, Action News 8 continues.
Now, more of our Jefferson Award honorees. These are people that receive awards each year, volunteers nominated by our viewers for the outstanding work they've done for their community. And this week, we are introducing you to the six honorees, and tonight meeting Jody Smith of Greenfield and Ruthie Watts of Seaside.
Why don't you leave your backpack in here? We'll get it afterwards, okay?
Special communities all have one. The go-to person. The one who sees the need and fills it. No muss, no fuss. Just get the job done. In Greenfield, that person is Jody Smith. She's the one who gets the call when somebody needs help.
Every once in a while, the phone rings, and I'm thinking it's for me to go to work. And no, it's the local police department calling for Jody because they have somebody who needs help in the middle of the night and that needs emergency shelter. And then she gets up, she goes to the church, and she meets the police officer there, and they get the vouchers ready, hook it up for the hotel room, and another person has a place to spend the night.
This is the most popular book in the world.
Today, she's in the library, a big cause for Jody. She's gotten many of these books on her own so that kids will have something to read, so they can learn and grow and better the community themselves. She takes nothing in return.
You know, a gift is a gift. We don't have to come back. Just pass it on to somebody else when you're able.
Now, the picture books take a little more work.
Paying it forward is a proven concept for Jody Smith. Besides the library books, which she paid for out of her own pocket, she has raised thousands upon thousands of dollars for so many organizations and programs in Greenfield. Programs allowing kids to grow, allowing those suffering to have what they need. For Jody, it is a calling.
I'm able to do it because I can just do, I guess, multitask. Yeah. But I just have to go back and give the Lord the credit.
Okay, we're getting ready, setting up for the movie. We have the first Friday of every month as a fundraiser for science camp for the fifth graders.
And it's a good thing that Jody Smith can multitask because the jobs can mount up. She's coming on 20 years of selfless service to her community. And the need has never been greater.
We have people who have no food, no lights. A lot of people can't pay their water bill, their rent. We just try to help every which way we can.
I've had the pleasure of working with Ms. Smith for a long time, and I'm just out of my mind with excitement about his Jefferson Award.
Whether buying or stocking books, teaching Sunday school, driving kids to camp, or raising money so that they can go, Jody Smith has been there. She is there. She sees a need, she fills it. The Boy Scouts need something, she gets it. Jody Smith provides the elbow grease in Greenfield, and we're lucky to have her. As for her reward, the service and a smile is all she needs.
It's a lot of work, but it's very rewarding.
And we do have a few special guests. Everybody's special, but we have a few guests that we really need to introduce.
This is Ruthie Watts. She is heading up a meeting of the Ad Hoc Committee in Seaside. Ad hoc, if you didn't know it, is Latin. It means to this, generally addressing a specific problem or task. Well, that's Ruthie Watts. She's pretty ad hoc. Over the years, dedicating herself and her time to this and to that and to other things, too. And the community loves her for it.
I feel as if we'd be like Jimmy Stewart in It's a Wonderful Life without her. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I arrived here in Seaside in 1965, and I decided to get involved in my community, and I've been involved in NAACP, and I had a whole lots of organizations here on the Monterey Peninsula.
You would like to buy some tickets? 6 for $5.
To this.
15.
And to that. That means countless committees and programs promoting civil rights, community improvement, and helping children.
my biggest focus is with the youth. I love working with young people. And like the Salvation Army and the Lynx and NAACP.
From the Salvation Army to the NAACP, Ruthie has quietly, modestly made a world of change in this community.
Ruthie is to the Monterey Peninsula what Rosa Parks is to our country.
Well, I wasn't going to slip that in there. I'm sorry.
She has served in countless capacities with the NAACP. She also co-founded the Coalition of Minority Organizations, Coalition of Scholarship Organizations, past president of the Monterey Bay Lynx. She organized the first Black History Month program. She does her work quietly, but has tremendous impact and is a remarkable inspiration.
If we're not paying attention and really looking, we don't see how one single life enriches all of our lives. And it's regardless of race, creed, or color.
A community is only as good as its people. And with people like Ruthie Watts, this community has become a very special place.
And I'm just a community person.
Well, we are going to introduce you to another pair of this year's Jefferson Award honorees tomorrow on Action News, beginning at 6:30 or so on Action News Sunrise. Then, of course, on Action News at 6, you can learn more about the program and our honorees at KSBW.com.